Since so many of you have asked for this radio, I did pick it up. I actually wanted to do it anyway. But this is the Baofeng UV10R. So this is the next model number after the UV9R, which I did a couple of videos on the UV9R. There was an 18 advertised 18 watt model that only did like 5 or 6 watts. There was another model that was advertised at 20 watts. It only did 5 or 6 watts. And then there's the Meerkat model that did 5 watts, but it was advertised at 5 watts. So it was all good. But today we're going to take at the fairly new, not really new. It's been out for a while now, but I got the something I'll mention real quick. Don't get this from Wish. Okay, this is advertised on Wish, and I think I've seen an ad where it's advertised at like 30 or 40 or 50 watts or even 100 watts. Some of those I think are fake news on Facebook. People are just having fun with Photoshop, which is quite hilarious, actually. But this is a regular radio that I got from either eBay or Amazon. I don't remember which one right now. I will put the link in the description below. Let's take a look at it. Ham Radio 2.0, where we do reviews, news, and how-tos of things that are new in amateur radio, two-way radio, GMRS radio, FRS radio, some CB radio upcoming. This is the newish, one of the newer models from Baofeng, and it is the UV10R. So I wanted to get this on camera today and look and see what it looks like, go through the menus, and put it on the, we're going to put it on the power meter also, because why the heck not? So this is the box. It's a new yellow box. Quite frankly, right there it says it's still limited to 128 channels. Which line is that? That's the third line down right there. It's still limited to 128 channels, which I think is a little bit fail. I think it's just a little bit fail, because they've got like, how many models of radios does Baofeng have now? Still limiting to 128 channels, really? So this is a inline earpiece, PTT. There's an antenna, charger. Okay, nothing else special in there. Get rid of that, put that over there. This battery right here shows to be listed at 8,800 milliamp hours. 8,800 milliamp hours in that battery? I doubt it. I doubt that is accurate. Very much doubt that is a true statement, but I don't know. We'll see. So on the back here, let me zoom down on this real quick. On the back of the radio, there we go. So we don't have, so the first thing you should notice is that BF UV10R is the model. Power is less than or equal to 16 watts. Yeah, I bet that that's true. Less than being applicable. Serial number, Baofeng Electronics. This came from Amazon. No FCC, no CE certification. There's the battery, 8,800 milliamp hours. I seriously doubt that that is true. So, oh, it comes up with 220. Okay, then. So this is not listed as a tri-band radio. 65 to 108 megahertz, only commercial FM radio reception. So that's just FM broadcast radio is what that is. VHF 136 to 174, receive and transmit. UHF 400 to 480, receive and transmit. That's the only thing that it lists. All right, so 8 watts is what it lists for power right here. Audio output, la la la. Okay, so this is the manual that came with the radio. All right, so right now, I can tell you right now, it transmits at 250. Wait a minute, I wasn't on. Hold on a second, make sure. Yeah, it's transmitting on 258.925. Okay, you're probably hearing that in the microphone. This is lighting up red when I'm hitting the PTT button. So, okay, 224. Oops, no.
Frequency mode.
Aha, okay, so that's a channel.
224200.
Okay. Okay, it does transmit in the 220 band. So, that is good to know. It's not advertised to do that, but it does do that. Okay, let's go through the menu real quick. Okay. First of all, let me go around the radio real quick. VFO, memory channel mode right there. AB for top and bottom band. Menu, exit, standard keypad here, up and down buttons. BF UV10R. It's got a call button here. You can see that in the light right there. Call button, that's your PTT. That's your monitor button. The monitor button actually turns on the flashlight. Short pressing it does. There it goes. You long press the monitor button, it turns on the monitor. Short press the call button, it turns on the FM stereo. It does have the standard K connector over here on the side. Okay, it's got the battery charger is right there. So you can charge the battery from the cradle or from a carry charger. That's kind of cool, I guess. No USB charging. Belt clip is attached to the radio itself, so if you get a second battery, there's no need to get a second belt clip. I always like that feature. This antenna looks like a UV5R antenna, and generally speaking, those are kind of junk. So I would probably, if I was going to carry this around, which I'm not, I would probably ditch this antenna and get a real antenna for it. So let's see. So let's go in here. The menu has 40 menus. 41, actually, because that's zero. That's menu zero. The squelch is menu zero. Step. Goes down to 2.5 kilohertz step, so that's good. It does not do the 8.33 kilohertz step for the aircraft band. Transmit power has two settings, low and high. Okay, that's good to know. The rest of this, just basic standard Baofeng or ocean menus. Yep, okay. So what I want to do is put this thing on the power meter because, well, number one, I want to test. It says it's 8 watts in the manual that we just looked at. So I want to test that on high power on the 2 meter and 440 band, but I want to test power output on 220 as well. So let's go over there to the power meter I've got. This is my MFJ 849 digital power meter. Really appreciate MFJ for letting me use this power meter. It's really cool looking, the cool looking power meter right there. I used to use my analog one, or my analog meter, and the one with the analog meter. This one's a digital meter, so you get a bit more precise reading with it. And I'm going to go right here, and you can see I'm at 146.520 at the top there. And I'm going to make sure we're on high power. My microphone, yep. Low and high. There's that. Okay, so keying up there. Ooh, 6.3 watts. Hey, that's not bad. Advertised at 8 and it's doing 6. That's not terrible. I'm not too disappointed with that. 44600. We're still on transmit high power. Okay. Ooh, that's disappointing. Less than 4 watts. 446. Let's try 441. 4, 4, 1, 6, 0, 0. Still less than 4 watts. Okay. So, a little bit over 6 watts on VHF, a little bit under 4 watts on UHF. Now I want to try 220. 223.500 is the national calling frequency for 220 1.25 meter FM simplex. So let's look at that. Oh, look at that. 6 watts on FM simplex. It does more on the 220 FM simplex band than it does on the 440 FM simplex band. It's not even supposed to transmit on 220. 2, 2, 4, 2, 0, 0. Boom. About 6 watts. And there you go. We're going into a dummy load here. There is not any transmission actually happening. I did transmit on 258.something megahertz when I got it out of the box because it was programmed for that. So I quickly unkeyed. I am in the shack here, and since, like I said a minute ago, the antenna on this thing is likely kind of junk, so it probably didn't even get out of the shack. Who knows what the SWR on it was. But that is the Baofeng. Trying to say that correctly for those of you who care about that sort of thing. UV10R, which is actually a tri-band radio. Not really supposed to be a tri-band radio, I don't think. I wonder how high it will go. 8, 0, 0, 0, no, it won't go to 800 megahertz. 7, 0, won't go to 700 megahertz. 0, 0, 5, 0, 0, 0, It goes up to 520, like 519.995. Okay. 5001. No, it won't go down below. 0011000. No, it won't. 136 is about the low as it'll go. It won't go to 350 megahertz, which is a common band overseas. So it's almost like they want it to go to 220. Goes to 250. Doesn't go to 260. Goes to 259.999.99875 is where it goes there. So it goes up there 200. It'll go down to 200. Goes from basically 200 to 260 megahertz, roughly. So there you go. So it covers the entire 220 band outside of the 220 band, 220 amateur band for the USA. Full open transmit from 136 to 174, 400 to 520, not a Part 90 radio. But again, there's no FCC sticker on it. They're not trying to market this to amateurs in the U.S. Well, maybe they are. I don't know. I don't know what they're doing. But that's the UV-10R. My suggestion would be to go get a radio that's actually doing what it's supposed to do. That would be my suggestion. A lot of you may come along in the comments and talk about how, well, I picked one of these up. It was a really cheap price. I'm like, okay, well, that's cool. And technically, there's no such thing as a Part 97 radio, because as amateurs, we can build our own transceivers and build our own transmitters. And they have to work to a certain amount of specs, but there's no such thing as a Part 97 type accepted radio. But at the same time, you don't want to use something that's splattering all over the band, and you don't want to use something that's built for something that it's not being advertised for. But let me know if you have the UV-10R, if you use it. Let me know what you think about it. I mean, transmitting just over 6 watts on both 2 meters and 220 should sound okay. I might try to do some All-Star with it and see how people on the other end of the 220 All-Star node think it sounds. Might be an idea. 73, let me know what you think about this radio below, and we will catch you guys next time.